Propsim enabled MIMO OTA testing, future-proof integrated test solution for verifying the actual performance of a mobile device. MIMO over-the-air performance testing is used to verify the end user's experience when accessing data services on a mobile device. Anite's range of Propsim channel emulators offers comprehensive MIMO OTA testing capabilities. Propsim is compatible with both anechoic and reverberation chambers. This video will focus on the use of anechoic chambers. Propsim creates realistic RF conditions that it presents to the MIMO device within an anechoic or reverberation type chamber. MIMO OTA testing performed in an anechoic chamber fulfills all technical requirements set by 3GPP and CTIA. It also enables the most consistent and reliable test results, even for future technologies and features such as uplink MIMO, COMP, and adaptive antennas. Let's take a look at how the equipment is set up for MIMO OTA testing in an anechoic chamber. The base station emulator emits RF signals that pass through the channel emulator, which applies a realistic fading model to the signals. A power amplifier amplifies the signals that are then received by the MIMO device placed on a turntable in the middle of the chamber. The uplink signal from the device is emitted back to the base station emulator. The entire setup is typically automated and controlled by a PC. Anite's Propsim F32 can test up to 32 channels in a single box. This makes it a future-proof and cost-effective solution for testing carrier aggregation-capable LTE-Advanced devices that require a greater number of channels. A single Propsim F32 emulator can support a configuration of 8 or 16 dual-polarized probe antennas, creating a multi-probe environment around the device under test for even more accurate performance testing. Propsim supports Anite's Channel Model Validation Tool, the first of its kind to meet 3GPP's and CTIA's specifications. This, in combination with Propsim's superior RF performance and high signal dynamic range, leads to more accurate results. The dual polarized probe antennas are placed in a horizontal ring around the edge of the chamber and transmit the signals. The uplink antenna is located in the corner of the chamber. The MIMO-capable device is rotated in 30-degree steps. In other words, the device is rotated and measured in 12 different positions. Device placement is typically optimized to mimic natural usage pattern. Once the device is placed in the chamber, the test run is initiated. Signals are generated by the base station emulator, faded by the channel emulator, and then transmitted over the air to the MIMO device inside the chamber. For each power level, data throughput achieved by the device is measured as the device is rotated in 30-degree steps. The average is then computed, and the result is displayed like this. Typically, the measurement stops when the throughput has dropped below 70%. The testing procedure generates a performance curve that displays the power required to reach maximum data throughput. The x-axis represents the power in decibel milliwatts, and the y-axis, the data throughput in megabits per second. Well-performing devices require less power to reach maximum throughput, resulting in this type of curve. The over-the-air performance of one device can then be compared with that of another device. Propsim F32 is suitable for OTA testing in an anechoic chamber thanks to its high RF input-output capacity, compact size, ease of use, and configurability. Propsim's superior emulation accuracy and quick test execution lead to more reliable test results and accelerated device assessment. When customers expect more from mobile devices, Anite helps you deliver.